I told about how art is created and how the natural emotions of the world, they are sublimated. Art is the sublimation of life. Professor M. Hirina, one of the greatest connoisseurs and aestheticians and great philosophers of our time, he says very clearly, till we realize the highest truth, that is Brahmananda, whatever, that is the perfect thing. And before that, where we can get perfection, it's only in art. Because art is the most cherished aspect of life, the best aspect of life. I always give one example. In our home, we have kitchen, bathroom, toilet, or restroom according to American English, and then sit out, drawing room, bedroom, and so many things. Kitchen is very important, so is the bedroom. We spend not less than 6 to 8 hours there, and kitchen, without that we can't live, and we need bath, toilet, and all these things. But much of our effective time will be spent in the drawing room. We neither cook nor bathe. We don't sleep, not even we have any other mundane activity. It's the most rewarding activity of inactivity. We enjoy life. Enjoy means what? Becoming aware of ourselves. That is the real enjoyment. I used to teach values in Chain International Essential Institution. There, all the young boys and girls, they used to come. They always used to think of their future. I should be that, I should be this, like that. And all the people used to say one thing, we want to enjoy life. After earning money, we want to enjoy life. How you enjoy? I'll be going to Louvre Museum and watch the paintings there. I'll be going to that sonata or that symphony or even some other Hollywood shows and something like that. Well, if you don't even know what is death and what is intensity and what is strokes and what is Dadaism, what is Cubism, what is Pointillism, what is that you are going to enjoy in Louvre Museum? If you don't know what is pitch and what is tremor and what is bass and what is viola and what is piano, without knowing all these things, what do you enjoy in music? So, even before enjoying, you should know something about that. So first, know art appreciation. Like that, I used to start them appreciating art. Like that, we cannot be perfect throughout the 24 hours, throughout the 365 days. At least for a while, we can be perfect. Here I have a classic example of my friend, Dr. Shankar Rajaraman. He never wants to pollute and soil the paper by scratching. Whenever he versifies mentally. I'll be just kindling him. No, you'll be erasing, you'll be rewriting the mind, don't you? Like that. But the beauty is, he has kept in his mind his poetry and the image of a poet more chastier than his life. The most enriching aspect of him, he thinks that it is poetry. Because of this, we cannot be complete persons, we can't be perfect people all the years, all the days and all the hours of the day. But at least for few moments, for few hours, for few seconds, we can be. What is that perfection? Ananda. Ananda is the perfection and nothing else, nothing apart from that. And for that, art is the best way. I told earlier, it is the sample dose, test dose. Before giving long course of penicillin and such antibiotics, some test dose will be given. If you withstand that, then so. So if one cannot appreciate art, means he cannot get moksha. Any person can say anything. This is our mata, alankarika mata. Because there is a proverb in Kannada, attakki haradavaru bettakki haratara. Those who cannot even go up to the terrace level, can they ascend the sky? No, it's not possible. Like that, this is the test dose. Even for a moment, if you can't forget yourself with awareness, even the sleep we forget, even when we faint we forget, but that is tamas. Here it is sattva, sattvodreka. We know that something is going on and yet we are not aware of ourselves. This way of transcendental reality, at least for a moment occurs in the day-to-day lives, and that is the beauty of art. And hence, we have to bother more about art. That's why a society which may be highly civilized, but if it is not cultured, what is the use? Material achievement is civilization, while cultural achievement, that is, while the spiritual achievement, non-materialistic achievement is culture, and this aspect of culture is very, very important. And here I have drawn some images to show how an artist and a connoisseur, they make a pair. I told about Sahradaya and Kaviyar Kalavit. Kalavit means he who creates art. Here is the artist and here is the artist, as I told, Verma, V.K.S. Verma Skyning, Sahradaya, connoisseur. These are the two triangles and these are the prisms. We know how dispersion occurs. This prism has three faces, glass prism. And what are the faces? The base is Pratibha. To become an artist, one should have first Pratibha, inborn imaginative power. And then Vyutpatti, erudition, and then Abhyasa, practice. All the three are important, but this is the most important. Without Pratibha, nothing can be created. Sahichakshur Bhagavataha, Tritiyamiti Giyate, Yena Pashyanti Bhavartan, Rasans Trailokya Vartinaha, so says Mahima Bhatta. This is a third eye by virtue of which any transcendental reality can be visualized. Pratibha, Prajnana, Vanonmesha Shalini, Pratibha Mata, like that Bhattatota says. I shall come to those details later. And Vyutpatti is erudition. People may have imagination, but imagination should be aided with, should be fragranted with, should be polished and burnished with this Vyutpatti, erudition. For example, you see, I can take one example from dance, Dr. Padma Subramanyam. She, in performing Bhagavad Gita, at the instance of Swami Dayanand Saraswati, she took up the assignment of performing Bhagavad Gita on the stage, where Vishwarupa Darshana is very magnificently presented. It is tantalizing, horripilating. And there, who are you? Arjuna asks Krishna, who are you? Then he says, Kalosmi. Kalosmi loka kshayakrat pravruddha. I am the time, T capital time, the time, absolute time, which consumes everything, kalanat kalaha. And there, on her face, she is showing all the fury of time. Sarva bhakshaka, everything is consumed. Time is merciless and ruthless and destroys anything. That's why Bhartavari says, Saramya Nagari Mahansan Rapatihi Samanta Chakranchatat Parshvetasya Sa Vidagdha Prishat Paschandra Bimbananaha Udvruttasya Rajaputra Nivaha Te Bandinaha Takataha Sarvam Yasya Vashatagat Smritipatham Kalaya Tasmai Namaha. That wonderful empire and such a brilliant king and those heroes, those arrogant, proud knights around the kings, and also the wise men of wit, men of letters, and the beautiful damsels, all these people went to oblivion because of Kala. They just became part of our memory. They were flushed out into the drainage of memory. To such a Kala I salutate. That is Kala. She is showing wonderfully all that expressions of Kala, but at the same time, by the feet, she is showing all the varieties of Kala. Kalosmi, 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 like that in Khanda Chapu, in Mishra Chapu, in Sama, in Trishra, in Vishama, all this gati she is showing, and that is erudition. This is Pratibha on the face, is the Adbhuta of Sattvika Abhinaya, that is Pratibha. Sattvika means it is the innate emotional richness shown, especially through the face. Everywhere you can show, this is pronouncedly seen. Sattvika bhavas, vibhuti is face. Bhuti is the rest of the body. But by the tapping of the feet, she is showing the count kala because it is dance. She is an erudite artist. And that's why Pratibha shows this expression. Panditya Vyutpatti shows this aspect also. And both come together so beautifully. And she does effortlessly, and that is Abhyasa. Once Tennyson was told by a very, very great admirer about one poem of him, a poem from In Memoriam. This is a well-known poetry collection. That poem is so beautiful. When I read, I always feel that it is as though written just like this. Then Tennyson told, I spent 2 cigars on that. People may be knowing how slowly they enjoy, the connoisseurs. They enjoy very slowly cigar, like that contemplated way. But abhyasa, practice, again and again, revisiting, polishing, changing, doing it again and again. One great stage actor by name Garrick, he tells one thing. If I don't practice, in the first day, myself will be knowing. In the second day, my fellow actors will be knowing. In the third day, my connoisseurs will also know. Fourth day, nobody will know, for I'll be out of stage. Abhyasa. Asamshayam mahabaho mano durvigraham chalam abhyasena tu kaunteya vairagyena cha siddhit. So this is what important. And so these triangles, these faces of the triangle, vyutpatti, abhyasa and pratibha, all are very important. That's why it is sadhana. People think that without abhyasa we can skip. No, it's not possible. To have that smoothness, to have that finesse, how much one has to practice. It's only a great artist will be knowing. And the improvement, the increment, in the technical language we call delta T, delta, it will be very less. But it will be known only to an artist of the same caliber, to the same, they appear, who will be knowing very much. And here is the artist. He'll be feeling the world. Artist from the world can itself, from the world itself, he can enjoy. The world will become the poetry of the Lord, at least for a moment. In the intensity of aesthetic enjoyment around the world, he immediately feels, realizes that ananda, and that is expressed in 7 colors. God's creation is something like the white color. When a person is bestowed with these 3 things, pratibha, yutpatti, abhyasa, he can analyze that, disperse into 7. The details. What is art ultimately? I always say it is the slow motion of life. The vividity with which we can behold the life. Many people will just, in a very crude way, in a cursory manner, they look at the things. They don't observe the things. The detailing is very, very important. That's why an artist will have his eyes always riveted to the subtle details. See, you just think of a story like Mahabharata, a story like Ramayana, a story like Iliad or Odyssey or whatever, even great novels. It can be told in 2 or 3 pages. How come they elaborated that? Why you just think of a film and try to narrate the story? In 5 minutes, we'll be completing. The detailing can only be done by an artist. Some people among your friends, among your family members, they'll be having the talent of vividly recreating it. Reporting and narrating are 2 different things. Reporting is very dry, it's summary. Narrating is recreation, vividly told. And that vividity is the dispersion in 7 colors. All the 7 colors are hidden. Many times you'll not be knowing. Only when the artist says, you'll be knowing. Many such examples I can bring out from literature and even from dance and films and all other things. But let me take from literature itself, as my friend Shankar will be introducing to that world in these future days. One example from Kalidasa's Meghaduta I shall take. Dirghi kurvan patumadakalam kujitam sarasanam pratyusheshu sputitakamala moda maitri kashayaha yatra strinam harati suratagglani manganukulaha shipravata pritamaiva prarthana chatukaraha. A wonderful poem it is. How the morning breeze comforts the women after a long night. And it comforts the women after a long sleepless night, you can imagine why. Like their beloved. It's comforting, massaging, entertaining, all these things are told. and how the breeze is coming. Dirghi kurvan patumadakalam skujitam sarasana. From the Shipra or Kshipra, the river which flows in Ujjaini, and on the banks of this sacred river we have Mahakala, the eternal lord of time, the lord of eternal time. And when the wind is blowing on the river, we have the water birds like cranes and even swans. And the swans and cranes will all be chirping. And the chirping noise, when a wind gently comes along that, when it passes through that, don't you feel that as though the sound of it is stretched? You can feel. When you have a rich music going on, if a breeze just rushes on that, you feel as though the sound is snatched or drifted into some other thing, because air is the medium of sound. Poet has observed. Dirghi kurvan, elongated, as though the sound is elongated, somewhere the wind is going. The wind has its own whims and fancies, we can't dictate it. Dirghi kurvan patu madha kalam. It's not just chirping, chirping of the birds. Patu, efficient, madha, in pride, in intoxication. And the air itself is so seducing, the breeze. And patu madha kalam, and yet it is very pleasant. Generally, intoxicating, arrogant or proud things may not be entertaining. We try to shirk away, shun it, but in poetry it is not. It's intoxicating and rewarding and inviting. Patu madakalam kujitam sarasanam. Their kujitam sarasanam dirghi kurvan. In those two long vowels, the elongation is felt. Dirghi kurvan, you can say dirghi kurvan. Dirghi kurvan patu madakalam kujitam sarasanam pratyusheshu. Pratyusheshu. The well, when the day breaks, you know, day breaks, but it has not fallen. Night falls, but it will not break. Pratyusheshu sputita kamala moda maitri kashaya. And the lotuses are blooming in the water. They have blasted out. They have opened their faces. Sputita. And so the day is so rewarding for them. They immediately want to look at sun, look at the world, and then bring out the fragrance and invite the bees, and so many things they have to do. They immediately in all hurry and bury, they open their windows. Sputita kamala moda maitri kashaya. Ah, moda, it's great fragrance. And in the fragrance we have an element of very, very enjoyable bitterness. A connoisseur of coffee will be knowing. People say that even a whiskey, no, I don't know that. I am aware of coffee. That bitterness is very rewarding, or the menthi, what we say, that has its own taste. Bitterness, to enjoy bitterness, we need some amount of maturity. Children cannot enjoy. So even this proud kala, it needs some maturity to appreciate. Patu madha kalam kujitam sarasanam sputita kamala moda maitri kashaya. And maitri kashaya, it's a very, very affectionate, friendly bitterness. It's not a bitterness of enmity. Because you taste any fragrance, any scent, it will be bitter to taste. Sweet and fragrant things cannot go on. You just taste, even the cardamom or even the kesar or whatever, it is not sweet. It's not even hot. It's not even the salt. It's not even sour. It will be having a shade of bitterness, gentle or strong. It depends. The poet has observed, the fragrance has gone to tongue now. So many senses working together. And then, kshipravataha. Yatra strinam harati surata glani manka anukulaha shipravataha. Here, the air is given so many adjectives, the morning breeze, the elongation of the sound, there the movement is seen, the gikurvan. Patu madha kalam, the sound, kujitam. And then, maitri kashayaha, the fragrance and the taste. And then, anganukulaha glanim harati. Body massage is being done, there sparsha. The panchendriya, five senses are brought together by a poet. So deep and so intense. This can only be done by a poet of very high acumen who has deeply observed. Oh, it's morning breeze, I say. We say that. But Kalidasa cannot say that. When once we have gone into the world of Meghaduta, we can't even say so. This is how detailing means what? almost we have conquered time. We have decelerated time. We all know what is the secret of longevity. In the Smriti of Manu, it is said, Rishayo Dirgha Sandhyatva Dirghamayo Ravapniho. This age is because of Dirgha Sandhya. Sandhya invariably associated pranayama. When pranayama is done in long hours, it is said in the Shastras that we are having certain amount of breaths that is fixed. We are sent with that. If we use in a judicious manner, if we can postpone death, we can postpone old age, something like that. It means make the life space slower and slower, retard life space, you'll be having more to live. Lifespan when it is fixed, you can retard. There's a story of Vikramaditya. Vikramaditya of Ujjain, he got the boon from Kali that he can live for 1000 years on the throne. He can sit on the throne and reign supreme the whole world for 1000 years. Then his brother told, for 6 months you sit here, for other 6 months I shall rule on behalf of you, because Kali has given me, blessed me with 2000 years. I told Kali, without my brother I can't live for 1000 more years. You are a wise man, you think. So Kali said, and now I am getting an idea. You sit for 6 months as a ruler here, and another 6 months you wander and get experience of the world. I will be ruling on behalf of you. What Kali told, 6 months for 1000 years you will be sitting on the throne. 6 months per year means 2000 years. In that way, it is the wisdom, elongation of time. In beautiful art experience, the time will be retarded because of the detailing, especially in classical art. In non-classical art, especially what we are getting, the hyped art, there time is accelerated, it is anti-productive. Whether it is the peppy music or peppy dance or Pulp Fiction or whatever, you just see, the characters will be rushing behind. Even in the films of action films and all, I do say that there is beauty in it, there is a way of appreciation, but the agitation, the speed and all, it is not bhavopashanti, it is bhavodreka. It's there separate. It's not the purview of this discourse. But this much is true, when our feeling is elongated without effort, not that we are digressing, poet naturally doing it, that is the way of vividity and detailing. And that's why great artists are very much for this detailing, and that cannot be duplicated. Our signature is in that. We know from biometrics that the thumb impression cannot be duplicated, and even the eyes, they cannot be duplicated like that. So the detailing makes a poet, and there is a style. Style is poetry, style is person, like that we have proverbs in Western aesthetics as well. Here comes Ritiratma Kavyasya, so says Vamana of our tradition. Style is poetry. Here, the detailing can be done because of these. And so, here is the vividity. Dirghi, Kurvan and all that, it is here. This is the breeze. One fine morning, Kalidasa on the banks of Ujjaini Shipra river would have wandered, immediately would have got this. This is the breeze. It's the poetry of the god. Devasya pasya kavyam na mamara na jiryati, so says Atharva Veda. The world is poetry of the Lord. It has no death and no old age. So, people who are capable of enjoying the poetry of Lord, they, for the benefit of others, they recreate and recreate. This is what happening here. And when we are Sahradayas, we are the yin yang like that, we are the counterparts. It is something like the Dampatya Yoga. Kavi Sahradayakyam Vijayate, inseparable entity, it is the inversion. And in the inversion, he too should have this Pratibha. Instead of Karayatri, he will become Bhavayatri. And he too should have erudition. To appreciate Padmasubramanian dance, that on the face we have Pratibha, on the feet we have Vyutpatti, I should have some Vyutpatti. And I should cultivate. Overnight we can't become connoisseurs. That's why Abhinogupta says, Yesham rasasvadana vashat vishadi bhute mano mukure varnaniya vishaya tanmayi bhavana yogyata te swahradaya samvada bhaja sahradayaha. Those who are constantly in touch with art, anushilana, Shil samadhu, that is the etymology. Samadhi means samyak adhiyate yasmin samadhiriti kathyate. Samyak adhiyate, well placed. That is shila. You say shila samadhu. Shila means it is character. Character means sustenance, endurance. We have to endure, and that is the nature of dharma as well. When such a thing happens, sustenance is there, means we have to constantly involve. Anu. Anu is the upasarga, that prefix means in touch with that. We have to constantly go and visit. Many people say, we don't have time. In 3 days, let me appreciate classical Indian music. In 3 days, we can't even penetrate into the walls of classical music concert hall. Concert hall. Because we should have the taste. I told, even to cultivate taste for bitterness, it needs certain amount of maturity. A 5-year-old boy cannot. Only a 10-15-year-old lad can. For 5 years he has to wait, he has to cultivate, he has to trial and error, do all these things. Such is the anushilana vashat, vishadi bhute mano mukure. The mind mirror should become clear. Vishada means pure, pristine, pure, clear. I told in the morning, that is, nairmalya taratamyena bimbitam chitta bhittishu. According to the cleanliness of our mind, the Saraswati will get reflected. So, all these things put together, he becomes sahradaya. And in him, he recreates. Sahradaya also, he creates the complete detailed effect in his heart. And then ultimately, he can feel the breeze of Kalidasa. That morning breeze, which Kalidasa had felt around 4th century AD or something, will be felt at any time by Sahradaya at any place. Even when it is in the scorching summer, or shivering winter, or whatever, you will be feeling it. This is possible because of the Bhavitri Pratibha of Sahradaya. And this background is very much essential for art appreciation, especially of classical poetry, classical art. Why often I am emphasizing on classical means, in classical, they go to a world of timelessness. But in contemporary, it is the imitation. But in classical, it is the exalted imitation. You see, just the film and television serials and all, you just see, to act, you need not learn anything special apart from some skills. You have to know, in a commercial film, dance, fighting, or make a gym-toned body of 6 packs or 16 packs. It goes like that. But in classical art, you may have to know so many other things as well. So many other things make it. And to just tell you, I am very fond of narrating a story from Markandeya Vishnu Dharmottara Purana, where a king by name Vajra goes to Markandeya Maharshi and asks, I want to realize the highest truth, please tell me. The highest truth is beyond form, nama, rupa, tita, anirvachya, paranada, like that he says. That is the unstruck sound, anahatanada, the cosmic vibration, something like that. Who is so difficult? Can you just concretize? That has to be taken in the form of images. That gunatita can be made saguna and sakara. Many people wrongly confuse nirguna and nirakara with something else. Nirguna means not devoid of any virtue, all virtues put together. You see, sky has no boundary means, is it a non-existent thing? Water has no shape means, is it a non-existent thing? Like that, nirguna is sakala guna and nirakara means sakalakara. An amoeba has a shape, but you can't describe this shape. It's anirvachya, and any shape is that. So, a shapeless thing is not a non-existent thing, and that is how we have to visualize. And coming back to this aspect of Markandeya and Vajra, concretize. Then he says, you have to worship the images. To realize the intangible, we have the tangible image. We have many avatars, archa avatara, rupa avatara, leela avatara, vibhava avatara, amsha avatara, avesha avatara, purna avatara. This is the archa avatara. Incarnation in the form of an image. Well, teach me how to do, how to make the images. For that, before making a sculpted one, you have to paint or sketch. Tell me how to sketch. To make a static image, make a static sketch, you have to know the dynamics of dance. Because you all know, in the morning I visited the temple where Sri Rama, in the form of Mahavishnu, there you have the Tripataka Hasta, and then Kattyavalambita Bhangi, and then one hand having Sarpashirsha Hasta. Like that it is there. Even without Shankha and Chakra, by the Tripataka Hasta, we can infer that Shankha and Chakra are present according to dance language. And when Alapadma Hasta is shown, lotus is there, or Kataka Mukha Hasta, or Kapita Hasta, like that, so many things. In that way, you should know dance. Without dance, how can you know this is Sama and this is Vaishnava? Like that, all these Thanakas have to be presented accordingly, and that's why you should know dance. Teach me how to dance. Dance works with rhythm, because dance is movement in space. It is the activity of time in space, and that's why you should know time, that is rhythm. Tell me about rhythm. Rhythm is Nada Shrita. Unless you know the notes, you cannot have a pleasing rhythm. Tak, tak, tak is not Tala. It is sound. Taka dimi taka janu, that is Tala. Zari gari gari magama, like that is what. So Nada. Well, teach me about Nada, Swara. That will become Shushka without Sahitya. You need Sahitya, literature, lyrics for that. Teach me lyrics. For that, you should know imagery, figures of speech, grammar, and all. Teach me grammar. For that, you should know how the sounds came into origin. Teach me how that is from the Paranada. Where we started, where we ended. That's why so many things are connected in classical art, and they are transcendental in nature. In the very moment they become eternal, they become importance of eternity. And here it is not imitation, it is exalted imitation. See, how a college going boy will behave. For that, if you just go to a college and observe, you can see. But how Rama behaved, you can't go to a college. If you present Rama as a college student, it may be true, Rama too was a student. But we are conditioned in such a way that we can't appreciate. Rama should have a gait. Rama should have a stature, Rama should have a language, he should have a vocabulary. For that, you have to separately study. See, so many times, so many people, they miss out. In our films and all, it is dubious. Very wrongly, they do all these things. In TV Mahabharata serial of B.R. Chopra, at one place, Bhima will be chopping onions. Onions were not present during the time of Mahabharata, they came from Central Asia. Only during the time of the second edition of Charaka, not even the first edition of Krishna Atreya. Only by the time of Amarakosha, onion got settled in India. So, and some croton trees were seen in the garden of Virata. Croton was imported in the 18th century in India. Earlier they were not present. And sometimes the Pandavas in exile, when they are in Vanavasa, they will be having Yajnopita Apasavya. Not like this, like that. That will happen only in Shraddha Karma, in Pitra Karma. This is how we show Brahma. This is the Upaviti, and this is Prachinaviti, and here is the Niviti, like that. All these things one has to study. In well-known Utsav film, at one place, Charudatta will be playing Sitar. Sitar is a later invention. Earlier it was only Rudra Veena. So these are the things which you have to study. The erudition is needed. It's not mere imitation of the world around us. We have to do a lot of search and research, and also it is exalted imitation. And more than anything, it is not what next, it is how next. What next is mere suspense. How next is real enjoyment. And that's why some people, if they had gone to a wonderful film, they come to me and tell, I will ask them, please narrate the story. No, I don't want to disappoint you by revealing this. You go and have the suspense. No need for that. Even the most suspense novel, suspense story, I read the last page and happily read the complete story. I am interested in the process, not in the product. Only in material life, product is important. In aesthetic life, it is the process that is very, very important. If my job is only to reach Cochin and come here, I have to rush by a flight or in such thing. But if I want to enjoy the journey, walking is better. If not having a bullock cart or having a cart driven by a horse, that is better than a flight where you will be seeing nothing but clouds. Sometimes even that also is not seen. In darkness, what we see. So, art is a journey, art is a process, and process is called sublimation, and that is anukirtana, not anukarana. And that's why Indian poetry is not bothered about the storyline much. Nirantara rasodgara garbha sandarbha nirbharaha girakkavi naam sthasyantina katha matram ashritaha. So says Kuntaka in Vakukti Jeevita. Great artists, they don't depend upon the story, they depend upon the originality in details. And that's why we are not tired of the Ramayana story or Mahabharata story. Why? You just see the themes in the world. Apart from love and violence, what else is there in the world? Shringara Veera, these are the only two main rasas. So the theme is that in love triangle or love pentagon, love heptagon, love hexagon, so many n number of films have been produced. Most of them have become successful, whether it is love story 84 or love story 42 or Ek Tujhe Ke Liye or Maro Charitra or whatever, everywhere it is that. It is the same thing. So the eternity of theme is realized by us in that manner. And also, one more beautiful aspect of Anukirtana is, more than the story I told about, the detailing is very, very important. And in the detailing, we'll be having so much of innovation, novelty, and filigree-like work being done. And that's why we don't find that our themes go outdated. We rely more on the basic emotions of human beings. That is rasa. I shall discuss about rasa siddhanta later. But this much is true. Detailing is the heart of that. And then the purpose of art, please. Please.
The detailing, will it lead us to this vachaka?
No. Wonderful thing. Detailing is not leading to explicitness of expression.
Vachyata, yeah.
Explicitness is vachyata. Detailing is done in a very, very suggestive manner, a vulgar, over-expressed way. I shall discuss that in when I take up the things about suggestion, dhvani and other things. I came to know that a friend from Hyderabad wanted to know something about dhvani. And then I will be discussing. It's a very difficult thing, but great people will do that. And the whole episode will be done with the undertone of suggestion. To take the example of Kalidasa's Raghuvamsa second canto, it will be better. In Raghuvamsa, Kalidasa's great epic, the king Dilipa, who was the ancestor of Rama, to be more precise, he was great-grandfather's father. Rama's father is Dashratha. Dashratha's father, Rama's grandfather, is Aja. Aja's father is Raghu, great-grandfather. And his father is Dilipa. And Dilipa, having no children, he goes to Vasishta. And then Vasishta is Kula Guru. He orders him to serve Nandini, the heavenly cow, and serve her. Then he will be getting the desired son. He'll be engaging in that. He'll be following Nandini wherever she goes. He moves there. Wherever she stands, he stands and waits. And for 21 days, he'll be doing the service like that. It is one period of allocation. And there, immediately, the cow enters into a cave. if you somewhere watching the beauty of the sublimity of Himalayan ranges, then somehow the cow has entered into a cave and there he hears the roaring sound of a lion and immediately rushes there, sees a lion has bounced upon Nandini and Nandini is pathetically looking at the king, especially by her looks he'll be moved and delighted, and then he requests, "You please kill me, I don't want this cow to be killed, you kill me and have your food but not this." So the conversation goes on. All this happened within the cave, and then lion says in the human voice, because it is a divine line ordained by Shiva, it says, "You have so much of beautiful body, handsome body, navam yavam kantamidam vapuscha alpasya hetor bhuvatmichan vicharam udas pratibhasimetvam," like that, "I think you are a fool. For a cow, for an insignificant cow, you are going to lose such a precious body and you are a king. So you are not a wise man. No, whatever may be, I have to protect like that. You kill me." He boasts to. Then what he say? When on him, not the lion which bounces upon him, it is the shower of flowers that he feels. Then looks at, it will be Nandini. It is a miracle of Nandini like that. And this detailing why poet has done, the thought that occurred in the Hridaya Guha of Dilipa. Dilipa had one thought. If at all some wild animal comes and encounters this cow, what I should do? Should I protect or not? To what extent I should do? Should I be tactful in it? Should I manage the situation? To prove that I have tried but failed? No, I should not. So the conflict which went in his heart is completely vividly described as what happened as a miracle. And even more sublime example is about Kumara Sambhava. In Kumara Sambhava, you all know Manmatha comes and shoots the arrow against Shiva when Parvati is going to approach Shiva. It is not Manmatha who is outside, it is inside. Harastu kinchit pratilupta dairyaha chandrodayarambha ivamburashu umamukhe bimbaphala daroshte vyaparayamasa vilochanani. Sanskrit grammar has come to poet in such a wonderful manner. In Sanskrit, like Greek, we have dual and plural also. Singular, dual and plural. Like that we have eka, bahu, dvi and bahuvachanas. All the three eyes of Shiva started surveying around the lips of Parvati. Started surveying. Vyaparayamasa. Vyapara means detailed movement. Not vilokayamasa. Vyaparayamasa. Vilochanani. Even the third eye of the Lord had become cool and calm and eagerly moving around the lips of Parvati. Poet is great. He can even shake his god Shiva. Kinchit parilupta dhairyaha. Only great poet can shake his god and be devoted to him. Like Rama in Vali Samhara or Sita Parityaga and Krishna in Ghatotkad Vaja, like Vadha, like that. We have many such instances. Only Vyasa Valmiki and Kalidasa, such masters can do, not all people. Worshipping heroes and heroism, our hero Rajinikanth or Amir Khan or whatever should never be deprived of by anybody. He should always win the combat with any number of people. That is the commercial film formula, like that cheaper poets would do. Our heroes, our gods should be kept intact. But master poets, they take the risk of even shaking their gods and yet be respectful with them. That is the hallmark of greater classicality. And here also, Manmatha comes, Chakrikrita Charu Chapaha, like that he is in the Alida Bhangi. Alida is one posture, like this. This is called Alida. And this is Pratyalida, offense and defense, like that. In Natyashastra we have all these postures. And here we have our Colonel Mr. Ghoshal. You said you may not be having any connection with art, and yet you have plenty of connection of war and art. I have written one article itself called Ranaranga and Rasaranga. Perhaps Arjun has translated that into English. Most of the dance movement are products of war movements. So it's not separate. Anka, act. Act is part of a drama. Anka in Sanskrit also means battle yard, battlefield. Like they have plenty of references. But I shall come to them later. Here, Manmatha comes and starts fighting, and he comes with his paraphernalia. Rati will be there, and then Vasanta will be there, and Malaya Maruta will be there. Amri, Manjula, Manjari, Varsharas, Satyam, Shukam, Yaddanu, Jayasyalikulam, like that. Plenty of things will come. The beast will be the bards, like that. Everything goes on. All this wonderful description is for showing the desire which arose in the hearts of Shiva. See, to say that Shiva developed desire for Parvati is one line, and that is the end product. But the process is the vaibhava of Manmatha outside, and that is the art material. This can be painted, this can be sculpted, this can be danced, that can be sung, so many things. But I developed desire is a statement which can be used by scientist, psychiatrist, not anything else. This way of detailing in a suggestive manner, Shiva developed desire, is a broad statement, that is Vachyata. Manmatha was sent by Indra. Who is Indra? Lord of Indriyas. Indriyadhipati Indra. And he, married to Shachi, is object of senses. Indrani Indriya Indra are the object of senses and senses coming together. Shabda, Sparsha, Rasa, Gandha, Rupa, they coming together with these five senses. That marriage is called Indra, Indrani Vivaha. In that sense, when we see a wonderful creation that Kalidasa made, great poets of any country at any time, they do this. In that way, detailing and then retarding the life pace and making the things enjoyable, like pranayama going on, and also relishing. If you want to taste ice cream, would you swallow? No. No connoisseur of ice cream would swallow that. On the tongue, he'll be keeping it and should slowly melt, and the lingering feeling should exist. You can't fast forward a song and hear. Can you hear? I want to hear 1 hour music. Fast forward, no. You can't accelerate that. You have to have that. What is music? It is the distance traversed between two notes. From sa to ri, how slowly, how detailed manner, touching all the gamakas, touching all the antar shrutis, in what a gentle manner you can pass over, you can skip over, you can glide over, slide over. That is music. What is dance? That occurs between two postures is dance. Between two postures, what movement occurs? The course of the movement is dance. Dance is not many images put together. It's not flashcards moving. It is total process. That's how we have all these. Sanskrit poetry is embodiment of that. Unless one has taste for classical Indian music, classical Indian sculpture, painting and classical dance, he cannot completely enjoy classical poetry of Sanskrit. That is true with any classical poetry of India. So also a person, if he is unable to enjoy Greek sculptures and then Greek mythology, Greek plays, Greek music and Greek way of life, he cannot enjoy Homer. So all this put together is that poetry or art is the most cherished aspect of life, I told. And that's why many Sanskrit scholars, sorry to say, Pathshala trained scholars, they do the postmortem of Sanskrit poetry, they don't enjoy. And that's why Neelakanta Dikshita says, they enjoy, dry scholars, traditional scholars or whatever, they enjoy poetry like entering a nymph or a ghost entering into the dead body, like that they enjoy. That's what Neelakanta Dikshita says in Shivali Raranabha. He was a great scholar also, a very great poet too. This way, erudition and all these things should enhance our enjoyment. And this is what even the Anubhav Vedanta too speaks. Adhitya Chaturo Vedan Vyachaya Ashtadasha Smriti Aho Shramasya Vaipalyam Atmapi Kalito Nache. Having studied the four Vedas, having studied all the smritis and other literature, if you haven't realized, if you haven't felt the Atma, what is the use of that? Atmapikal Shadangadi Vedo Mukhe Shastra Vidya Kavitvam Chagatyam Vichitram Karoti Manaschirna Lagdam Guru Ranjipatme Tatakim 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 Tatakim. You have so much of parallels between art and Vedanta. If a person is not well rooted in art, I doubt his Vedanta. And so also, if an artist is not moving towards Vedanta, I doubt his art. Kalapurva rupam, tattvam uttara rupam, rasasandhihi, bhavukata sandhanam, yityadhi rasam. Like that we can make a new mantra also. So, poetry is the pura rupa and Vedanta is the uttara rupa. Those who deny one will be denying the other also. Divedye veditavye, paracha aparacha. Avidyaya mrityum tirtva, vidyaya amritam ashnute. You can refer to any Upanishad, it is that. Hence, both are coming very close and very close to that. Now, we don't have much time. We have to go to the dance. And that is the real drishya kavya. I shall tell one thing. I wanted to say something about Natya Shastra. I shall just give an introduction to it within few minutes. Natya Shastra is the oldest available treatise on Indian art appreciation and Indian art production. It is the first available. Earlier there were Natasutra, Krishashva, Shilali were all present. Bhikshusutra, Natasutra, like that Panini himself says. And even in Harivamsha and all, we have plenty of references to such works. But this much is true. Bharata, in his own work, says Atra Anu Vamshyau Shlokau Bhavataha, Atra Anu Vamshye Arye, like that. The earlier masters who have done that, I am following and quoting, like that he says. And in Natya Shastra, 36 chapters are available and more than 6000 verses are seen there. Shatshastri Samhita, like that it is said. It is Panchama Veda. In our tradition, there are so many Panchama Vedas. Even Mahabharata is Panchama Veda, Ayurveda is Panchama Veda. What is Panchama? Panchama is something the space available in Pushpaka Vimana. Anything is the fifth one. So, always we have the extension Atyatishta Dashangalam. Like that the space is available. And it is also called as Sarvavarniko Veda. No sex, caste, creed, social bar. In Natya Shastra, it is said that the four pillars of a Natya Mandapa, they represent four varnas. Means whole society has to support art, not one caste, one creed, one gender. Everybody should protect, everybody should support like that. The very opening chapter of Natya Shastra, we have the creation, Natyotpatti, that is the Adhyaya's name. In Krita Yuga, people had enjoyment everywhere. They never used to work, they never used to plow, sow and reap. Naturally, the fruits, grains, everything were available and nothing used to be difficult for them and everything used to be enjoyment. At the end of Krita Yuga, they started feeling that work is something and we have to toil in that. They have to till, they have to sow, they have to reap, all these things they came into existence. And so, earlier it was just jai, ananda, now it is karma. Hence they got fatigued. Always work fatigues, but art will not. Karma yoga will not. How to sublimate work to act? You know, work is karma. Act is karma yoga. Acting, that's why we have that. Kala becomes kala yoga, karma yoga. And so here, they had this difficulty, how to overcome the fatigue. And there is one more interpretation for this. According to our Puranas, Krita Yuga was the Satya Yuga, then nothing was needed, everything went on. Anthropologists say that it is the very old prehistoric time, then people had no awareness of art. Gradually they developed an awareness for art, because art is imitation of life and it is called mimesis. From the Greek word you will be knowing, it is imitation. What morning hunting a caveman did, evening in the campfire, he is to imitate that. What is the jumping deer there, he is to imitate, and that became Mrigapluta Chari and Harinapluta Karana. What he got scared from a serpent, he did Bhujangat Trasita or Bhujangat Trasta Rechita. Rechita means extending. Extending because of a snake. A snake is moving, and when the snake appears, immediately we lift the leg. And lifting, that is Bhujangat Trasta Rechita, one posture in that Karana. And Rugapulaka, and then Gajak Kriditaka, or Karihasta, an elephant appears. How it appears? Its ears, how they are swinging and its trunk, how it is moving and how the body and the gait, all these things he started recollecting and presenting. That so his struggle in day became entertainment in the evening. That is what Kalidasa says. Rama and Sita after Vanavasa, they went to Ayodhya and they got their lavish palace, newly modified and well painted, and the painting subjects were the difficulties that they faced in Vanavasa. Tanyeva sukhanya bhuvan chitrani tanyeva sukhanya bhuvan. The difficulties faced long ago, now recollecting them in pleasant time will be very happy. Don't we verify from our own experiences, oh, I had so much of difficulty in my engineering, but I had wonderful colors with that, I came out like that, we start feeling proud. And that is how Wordsworth says, emotions recollect in tranquility. What is poetry? Emotions recollected in tranquility. Emotions worried. A recollected reenactment. In tranquility, quietitude. Morning I told, in the cool water bath, the flask is kept. One should be cool, tranquil. So this way of wonderful imagery has been given in the second interpretation as well. But according to Natya Shastra, these gods, demons and human beings, they all went to creator. Kridaniyakam icchamo drashtum shrotuncha yadbhavet. We need audio visual entertainment. This is the literal translation of that. Even today we need that. One of my friends who is a very good businessman and an venture capitalist, he says, Ganesh, nowadays for the world, art industry is most flourishing because all are getting good money. Money is flowing like anything. They all are die rich. Especially Indians are becoming richer and richer in the world. They need good entertainment. If not, they become demons. So, rasa samskara is needed. You please remind me. I shall narrate my interpretation of Samudra Mathana story sometime in future. Then you'll be matching that. How the Puranic stories have a metaphorical understanding of that. So they go to creator. Because creator has created all of us, he has to create something. Something new. Kridaniyakam. A toy. Entertainment value. We need that. All the people, they go. But Brahma also, he cannot create anything new. My friend was asking morning, how to avoid the problem of imitation? How to create new is the first problem. Brahma faced that. The creator faced how to create new. World wine in new bottle he did. Patyam jagraha rgvedat rasana atharvanadapi samabhyo gitamayvacha. And then from Yajurveda Abhinayam samabhyo gitamayvacha rasana atharvanadapi. From all the four Vedas, available Vedas, he collected one piece like that. Some Tilottama is being done. Tilottama is not a new apsara, new nymph. She was the best among the apsaras because the best present in everything was taken to the same quality, quantity. Tila Uttama, the best, one bit of it, one atom of beauty from everything was collected and amassed, that became Tilottama. Like that, from Rigveda lyrics, Yajurveda movements and Samaveda music and Atharvaveda emotions, he put together all these things boiled down into one thing, that is Natya Veda. It means Kutova Nutanam Vastuva Musprekshitum Kshamaha Vacho Vinyasa Vichitra Matramatra Vicharyatam. A great Nayayika of Kashmir, Jayanta Bhatta, says how to say things new, but we present newly. Don't you see from our advertisement the same thing in a new package, in a new color, in a new flavor, the same age-old paste but having new flavor, the same age-old soap but having new color, such things, something new, some design of new will be there, that is novelty. That's how he presents. But that novelty in art is a pronounced one, but in materialism it can't be so. So he creates that way. In art, novelty is not of the stuff, because in art it is narration. Novelty is in narration. And that's why you may be having a wonderful image being made of gold. But if it is not beautiful, it has no value for a connoisseur. Only a marketeer will be having better value, better price for that. It is not called value, it is price. But if a mud image, if an earthen image, if a graver image made more beautifully, that will have a greater value as art. Music produced from a golden veena may not be pleasing to hear, but from a wooden veena may be far more enduring. That's why it is not the material, it is the spirit in that. With this background, we have to watch it. I shall be the narrator there too. Punarayan Mahakapi, again I will narrate. And so, you please relax for a while and come and join with us for the dance.